Earlier this year, I got back into drawing and I decided to build up my inventory of different styles of pens. And when I was young, I used to enjoy trying to fit the alphabet in as small a line as possible. So here I am trying to beat my old record, and I put it up as a challenge to all of my students. And of course, they all tried, they all failed. Only just, so I know one of you is gonna smash this. Anyway, here's the challenge. Write the entire alphabet in under 9.56 millimeters. The very last time that I drew was possibly 25 years ago, especially to any degree like this. I decided to just jump back in with both feet, as I do with most things that I do, and I started off with a very large piece of paper, and I sketched out a rough idea of what I was thinking, and it was just completely from the head. This first sketch, a little wooden cabin on top of a man-made mountain, or a hill, and underneath there's a secret. There's a little wood stump that I'm drawing. So I decided that a story was going to go with this. I've yet to finish it, and this was some months ago. And really, the reason is I just got a little bit too depressed to kind of continue doing it. So my heart and my mind really wasn't in it. But I'm close to kind of clearing off the table and setting back up and just getting to it. You know, life is going by way too quick. And there's really not a moment to lose. So I do love drawing, and it's funny, the thoughts and the feelings and the stuff that I used to think about when I was 16, 18, 19 years of age, which was actually up until the age of about 25, the thoughts and the feelings that I used to think and feel back then come flowing back to me as soon as I started to draw. So it's kind of very therapeutic to jump back into those same thoughts and feelings of years ago and kind of, you know, file them away and kind of finish off that line of thinking. But it is strange, and I do find it weird that it's very cathartic and thought-provoking, and it helps you to recognize like a lot of stuff that's going on inside. It's a form of meditation, dare I say it. So here I am drawing a little spider's web, and I saw a friend, it might have been Andy on Instagram, I think I saw his spider that he discovered, took a photograph of. So I said, I'm gonna put your spider in my sketch. Here's a wooden post. So far I've drawn two sketches. Both have yet to be finished, but I'm a big believer in only working on something like this when you're 100% in it, because otherwise it's going to show, isn't it, in your passion, in your attention to detail. This is Grenick. Grenick is a character I'm creating for a story. There's going to be dragons in this story. I've always loved dragons. There's attributes and bits and pieces about this drawing that reveal quite a bit. But as of yet, I still need to go back in and finish it. I kind of semi-messed it up on a cobbled road that I was working. The cobbled road is way too harsh, so I gotta think about how I'm going to fix that. At first, Grenick was like a 60-year-old guy, but now I think he's a 50, 55-year-old guy that's just lived hard, you know? He's a drinker, or was a drinker. He has his flaws, and as I was drawing it, it kind of felt very much like myself, except I don't really drink. Here is a lot of the research that I was doing, some of the old postcards of Southwest England. Here's some of the scars from his battles, elements, the detail in his kind of fleece jacket. And then here is the harbour village, so to speak, with a large harbour wall behind, you know, most people are protected. So I don't know if I'm going to put in a picture of how this actual image stands at the moment. I may do, but maybe what I'll do is I'll put portions of it. So I'll dig up some photographs and put it in here so you can see the kind of the detail that I've been putting into this drawing. Again, more postcards from my childhood. I've collected these all my life, really, from Devon, Cornwall, Wales and the likes, and it's just great reference pieces to kind of, you know, what were old roads like, what were old buildings like, what was the structure like, and when you're trying to recreate that stuff. And I have a certain affinity for old galleons, old boats, and the like. The little boat there is not a true replica of what's in the postcard. I've changed much of what was reference material just to kind of help with the story, really. And throughout this very large piece is little telltale signs of who the story is really about, but you can't tell in this particular scene presently, as I'm just kind of roughing things in with pencil. These are little concrete bollards that iron chain is hanging from one to the next to the next, and they're just kind of a safety barrier to stop people, drunken people, walking into the harbour at night when the tide is full. So this is just, you know, a lot of the detail that I'm kind of putting in. The good news is that now I have a website that is getting more and more in line with what I was thinking of to begin with. I have a functional store. Some of the poster versions of these drawings will be available in the store. They're 100% my creations, and only available through my website. Also, I will put a link to all of the drawing pens, to all of the new items that I've purchased to be able to create these drawings from scratch. That will all be available on Amazon through my Amazon influencer link, so check that in the description below. Thank you for watching, and check tomorrow or Sunday, I'm hoping tomorrow, for the next boat build video. And of course, I'm really looking forward to seeing any one of you that have tried to attempt the mini writing, the alphabet, in as short as line as possible with any writing utensil.